So with that wonderful song, let us make a beginning to our class, Salesforce Management. Okay, I welcome you all. This is Dr. Mahesh M. Onjeri, Assistant Professor from Department of Management Studies, SDM College of Engineering Technology, Dharwad. Okay, so dear students, you are given a small case, okay, a one-page case, okay, to read and analyze the case. Okay, and understand the decision making situation over there and answer to the question at the end. So I have told it is not compulsory, because if I say compulsory, students will feel very bad and they start remaining absent. Okay, it will have repercussions on me also. So I told at least some of the students who are attending the classes regularly. Okay, and those who really feel interested in after reading the case. Okay, so I feel they might have made an effort, attempt to answer the question. Okay, so even if nobody has made an attempt to answer, no worry. Okay, so I will again guide you, okay, how to write an overview of a case and how to critically analyze the situation and arrive at a decision and how to explain or justify your decision. Okay, yeah. So let me share the case first. For those who have not read or not seen this case. So, okay, this is again a case from your textbook, chapter number one. Okay, so it's about Thompson Plastics Company making the transition from salesperson to sales manager. Okay, so those who join in field sales, okay, so you will get this opportunity, or you may get this opportunity to become a sales manager. Say, generally in India, we call it area sales manager. Okay, so this case is about making a transition from salesperson to sales manager. So there is a situation here. Okay, so who would like to give the overview of the case? You know by this time now, okay? What is the overview of the case? A brief summary so that everybody can understand and be on a common platform before we start discussing the questions. Yes? Anybody who has written or who is ready to orally give a overview of the case? Okay, so nobody has written overview of the case. As I mentioned, it was not compulsory. Thank you, everyone. Okay, and let me make another share. Okay, so that you can, okay. Now, before I give you the overview of the case, I'd like to mention, okay, some of the responsibilities of a sales manager. Okay, because our textbook does not cover, okay, what our textbook covers is policy issues or strategies of Salesforce management, but it has not covered the functions or duties or responsibilities of a sales manager. Okay, so if you are able to see this, okay, so if you are able to see this, okay, the response in general, okay, in general, I'm talking the responsibility of this sales manager. Again, I'm talking about a general manager sales at the head office level, general manager sales at the head office level. So the sales manager for Thompson has a large amount of responsibility for planning, okay, for planning the sales effort and a total responsibility for organizing and managing the sales force. Yeah, this is again, I'm sorry, policy making and a strategy level. So the responsibility of sales manager in this case is planning the sales effort and a total responsibility for organizing and managing the sales force in the area of planning. So what are the activities included in planning? In the area of planning, the sales manager must assist the preparation of the sales forecast. He compiles territory estimates. He compiles, sorry, sales manager compiles territory estimates by customer and by product based on history or historical data and forecasts of economic conditions and competitive developments. Based on the final forecasts, sales manager also prepares the expense budgets, okay, the maximum amount of expenditure allowed for each sales rep and the sales quota Sales quota means sales target. Sales quota for each individual sales reps. Sales manager then breaks these budgets or targets down into monthly and quarterly dollar figures or rupee figures, which he uses in evaluating the sales representatives and determining their incentive pay. Okay, so couple of the responsibilities of a general manager sales. Along with that, the general manager sales has a responsibility for recruiting and selecting new salespeople when there is an open territory. Sales manager places the advertisements in the local newspapers, screens the applicants based on their resumes, interviews those who appear to have the qualifications to fill the job, selects the candidate, and makes the job offer. The sales manager then spends 2 or 3 weeks training the new salesperson. This involves everything from acquainting the new sales rep with company objectives, production capabilities, and operating policies to teaching the product knowledge and selling skills. Okay, so during the training period, the new rep accompanies the manager on a number of typical sales calls. Okay, so other than that, supervision, motivation, and evaluation are essential components of this position. So I'm talking about general manager sales at the head office level. The manager makes sure that the reps are allocating their time properly and that they are keeping current with regard to their product and industry knowledge. He is responsible for weekly sales meetings and continuing training programs. He must also spend time in the field with each rep in order to evaluate performance. In conjunction with the evaluation, he designs and administers the recognition and compensation programs. Of course, the sales manager also acts as a troubleshooter when any of the reps needs assistance with an account. Account means customer. Okay. So if you look at this portfolio of responsibilities of the sales manager, definitely the sales manager need to be skilled, mature, and analytically very strong. Okay, so when the organization is smaller, it has fewer sales reps, okay, like up to 30, for example. Okay, all these things can be directly done by the sales manager. But where a company has a larger sales force, like hundreds of sales reps, 300 sales reps, 500 sales reps, 1,000 sales reps, then definitely the sales manager cannot directly involve in all this. So that is why, okay, these area sales representative in different territories are allocated to, okay, different managers in the hierarchy, like area managers and regional managers. And on behalf of the general manager sales, these regional managers and area managers undertake most of these responsibilities, except for sales planning, like forecasting. Okay, so this was one important information available in this case. So now I'll stop the share. But before that, I can just go through the case name Thompson Plastics, making the transition from salesperson to sales manager. Okay, now before I give you the overview of the case, anybody have any questions? Any doubts? Those who might have read the case but not prepared answer, if you have any doubts, or the responsibilities of sales manager, which I read out. Any question related to that? Any doubts related to that?
No, sir.
Okay. So in that case,
no, sir.
Okay. Thank you. In that case, let me continue and go ahead with the overview of the case. Okay. Okay, so those who have not read the case, it is for them, or even for other students also. So because in IA 1, 2, 3, okay, so I'm going to give similar cases. These are smaller cases. Okay, with and in IA, usually I give only one question for case study for 10 marks. So I will ask you to write the overview of the case and then make the decision, whatever decision is pending in the case, in the form of question. It will be single question only carrying 10 marks. So where I expect you to write 40% of your answer should be overview. So remember, you cannot simply copy the sentences from the case and rewrite. Try to understand. You have to read the case and write a brief summary the way it is mentioned here. It is still briefer. You can write a little bit more for 10 marks. So 40% of your answer, around approximately 40% of your answer should be the overview, and the remaining 60% of your answer should answer the decision making question, like should Lorna Kelly ask Ted Cook to give up his accounts? How do you think Kelly should handle this problem? So this is the decision making situation. So answer to this question should be around 60% approximately. So you cannot write for 80% of the case as it is from the case study, and you cannot write 1 or 2 points for this question. No? You will not get the marks. I hope, am I clear, students?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So thank you. So what should be the structure of your answer in examinations? At least answering question answer, you please learn. So approximately 40% of your answer should be about overview. Okay, so this is the overview. Okay, and about 60% of your answer should be addressing the decision-making situation with proper justification. Okay, so now first let's go through the overview. Thompson Plastics is a small growing company. So this company is smaller, that's why I said. Okay, so it has one sales manager, okay, who can take care of all the reps. It has one sales manager who has a large amount of responsibility for organizing and managing the sales force. Recently, Ted Cook was promoted. Okay, his name, sales manager's name is Ted Cook. Okay, so recently Ted Cook was promoted into the sales management position. Although he was asked to give up his accounts. Please remember, dear students, accounts means customers. Okay. Although he was asked to give up his accounts, his customers, he argued to keep a few of his most important accounts, most important customers. Means he will do two jobs. He will keep visiting his most important customers in the field, as well as he will also perform the job of a sales manager, because he insisted. It was not a question of money, because he was paid in such a way to more than compensate for his loss of revenue if he give up the accounts. So this objective of retaining and visiting the most important customer is not from money point of view. Whatever money he was going to lose by way of not making sales calls in the form of incentives was already compensated in the position of, or in the compensation of, sales manager. So it was not about money. He was too much. Okay. He liked the field so much, and he was concerned about his customers too much. Okay. And the marketing manager let Ted Cook retain the important customers. So then what happens? So Ted Cook starts working as a sales manager. I have read out all the responsibilities. Remember, sales planning, organizing and managing the sales force, all those activities. He starts working as a sales manager and start performing those responsibilities. But along with that, he also continues to meet his most important customers in the field. So due to which, what happens? Yeah. Lately, after some time, Ted Cook, the new sales manager, has been falling behind on his paperwork. So I read you out. That is the reason why I read you out the different responsibilities of sales manager, from sales forecasting, sales planning, allocating that sales quota, sales budget, sales expenses, okay? Then supervision, motivation, compensation of the sales reps, all those responsibilities, okay? So he was falling behind his paperwork, means he was not able to complete his duty as a sales manager, okay? And his sales figures have slipped, and one of the reps has complained about the lack of support from Ted. So it shows that Ted Cook was struggling to manage both the jobs, one as a sales representative, where he was visiting his most important customers on the field, as well as the responsibilities of sales manager. So he was underperforming in both the positions. As a sales manager, he was not able to complete his task, as well as he was not able to maintain the sales as a sales representative. So the marketing manager felt, okay, there is one more person above him. He showed marketing manager Lorna Kelly. So Lorna Kelly, the marketing manager, felt there was a chance Ted might quit if she made him up, give up the accounts. So Lorna Kelly was the marketing manager who was above him in hierarchy. So she could make him, she could make the sales manager give up visiting the most important customers. But if she did that, she was afraid that Ted Cook may resign from the job. Okay. And she would then have to replace a rep and a manager both. Then one sales rep vacancy will be vacant, as well as the job of a sales manager, both will be vacant. Again, it is a difficult task for Lorna Kelly, the marketing manager. So she didn't know what to do. So she was in confusion. So whether to allow Ted Cook to continue with both the jobs of sales rep or the job of a sales manager as well, or to ask him to stop visiting the important customers, stop the job of a sales rep and focus only on sales manager. But if you do so, there is a chances that he may resign from the job and leave the company. Then two vacancies will be created, one of a sales rep, one of a sales manager. Again, it is difficult for the new manager and new rep to get into the company, get the training and start producing. It will take some more time again. So she was in a dilemma. She was in a confusion. So this is the overview of the case. This is how you can go on explaining. This is only what I have written here is only for an examination evaluator. We cannot write a whole 2-page answer. So only the key points. Your answer should include these key points, but it should be more elaborative looking at the marks. Then the question is, should Lorna Kelly, the marketing manager, ask Ted Cook, the sales manager, to give up his accounts, to stop visiting the important customers whom he is meeting? How do you think Kelly should handle this problem? So see, all these cases what I'm bringing, they have a decision-making situation. So I have to read the case repeatedly and diagnose the case study, understand the situation, the characters or alternatives involved. Okay, then evaluate the alternative decisions. I told you the evaluate alternative decisions here are, the marketing manager can ask the sales manager to stop visiting the customers in the sales field so that he can allocate all the time to the position of sales manager. But what are the consequences of such a decision? Sales manager may resign and leave the company. Then the problem for marketing manager is she has to appoint one more sales rep and one more sales manager. And by the time these two start producing, it will be further, it will take some more time. So that is one problem. But if she allows Ted Cook, the sales manager, to visit the customers as well as manage, hold the position of sales manager, he is not delivering in both the places. That is also a problem. So we can consider two alternates here at least. So as a MBA student, you are actually placed in a situation where you have to evaluate both the alternatives, pros and cons of both the alternatives, and take a decision. I have always told you, the best interest of the company. This formula you should never forget. The decision should be always taken in the decision which benefits the company, the decision that improves the performance of the organization. That decision you must take. So one more call. Just anybody who has made an attempt to answer the question? Any student who has made an attempt? Half written is also okay, because you will have an idea. Anybody? Yeah, I'm asking, at least say no, dear students. No, otherwise I have to keep waiting. So nobody has written the answer. Not a problem. As it is not compulsory, but in examination, it will be a compulsory question. I hope you remember. As I use the word, same words are used here. One alternative. So this is one decision alternative. So one alternative in this situation. 1 minute. So one alternative in this situation is to allow Ted to keep his accounts. Means let Mr. Ted Cook, the new sales manager, who is from the same company, huh? Ted Cook was working in the same company since many years. He was promoted, internal promotion it was. So he is promoted as a sales manager. So allow him to keep his accounts, means allow him to work in the capacity of a sales rep and allow him to keep visiting the most important customers. His most important customers in the field. But talk to him about the fact that he is falling behind. See, in previous case also, call people and talk to them politely, diplomatically. You can resolve a lot of issues. But in our culture, okay, you know this. As a student also, you also might have behaved. You don't speak to people. Okay, here people don't speak to other people when there is a problem. They keep the grudge in mind. Okay, and they allow it to grow. And the problem remains unresolved. Remember, even in families it happens, in workplace it happens. Nobody is bothered about providing solution to the problem. Okay, so this is what we call open culture. Okay, diplomatic way of handling situations. So talk to him, talk to Ted Cook about the fact that he is falling behind. It means he's not able to complete his work as a sales manager, nor he is able to increase his sales as a sales representative. Okay, and also possibly give him some administrative assistance. Yeah, since he is handling two portfolios, one as a sales manager, one as a sales representative. Okay, some administrative assistance. Somebody from the company office, okay, can do some of his work. Not everyone, some of his work. Okay, so we call it administrative assistance. So to lower his burden as a sales manager. Okay, so what are the advantages of this alternative decision? The advantage of this alternative is that Ted won't quit. And it could help the situation. See how we are considering one alternative and we are evaluating the advantages and disadvantages of this alternative now. So the advantage of this alternative is that Ted won't quit. Ted Cook, sales manager, will not quit because he's happy. He's allowed to meet his most important customers. But the disadvantage, see, advantage and disadvantage of each alternative you have to consider. But the chances are pretty good that this won't solve the problems in the long run. Okay, as they may go worse also. Okay, the chances, the disadvantage of such a decision is where you allow the sales manager to work in both the positions. Sales rep, allow him to meet the most, his most important customers in the field as well as resume the responsibility of sales manager. If you allow him to do this, disadvantage is the chances are pretty good that this won't solve the problems in the long run and they may get worse. Okay, and remember, so if the sales manager is not able to organize and manage the sales force, company will lose sales. Try to understand. So beautifully and in simple way, the first alternative is evaluated. Okay, so there is another alternate. Okay. So it's called a better alternate because it is in the best interest of the company and it helps improve the performance of the company or help resolve the problem for the company. So what is the second alternate decision? Okay, the better alternative is to tell Ted that he must give up his accounts and go back or go back into sales. Okay, tell Mr. Ted Cook, the new sales manager, so either he has to work only as a sales manager or he has to resign from the position of sales manager and go back to sales job as a sales representative. Now he cannot do both. Okay. He has to undertake any one responsibility. So this is the better alternative. Let us see. Let us evaluate the advantages and disadvantages of this alternative decision for Lorna Kelly, the marketing manager. She should tell him that she hired letting him retain the accounts and that it is not working satisfactorily. See what we already know, that Mr. Ted Cook is also failing as a sales representative. He's not able to retain his most important customers and his sales is also decreasing. Sales target achievement is also decreasing. So she can tell this information to him directly. See, I allowed you to keep your most important customers, but neither you are able to retain them nor you are able to increase your sales as a sales representative. The advantages of this alternative first, okay, where Lorna Kelly, the marketing manager, is going to tell Mr. Ted Cook, the sales manager, that he has to give up his accounts. Okay, and work only as a sales manager, or he can quit as a sales manager and work only as a sales representative. So what are the advantages of this decision? Okay, she has authority and she can do it. The advantages of this alternative are many. The first advantage is it establishes a new policy with regard to sales managers. So in future, any sales manager cannot work in two capacities. So it becomes a policy. So this problem will not arrive in future. More important in the short run is that if Ted is willing to give up the accounts, he will have more time to devote to his managerial responsibility. Let us assume that Mr. Ted Cook also understands and he stops working as a sales rep. He stops visiting his important customers in the field. Then he can divert his entire time, devote his entire time to manage the responsibilities of a sales manager. That is what is required now. Okay. And the reps will get more attention and the reps will get more attention when Mr. Ted Cook will start working as a sales manager, okay, full time. Okay, the reps will get, sales reps will get more attention. And the customers who are assigned to new reps, see, Mr. Ted Cook was still retaining some important customers. So these customers now will be assigned to new sales reps. So these important customers will also get more attention from the new sales reps as they have time. Their job is to meet the customers in the field. Okay, so of course Ted may choose to go back into sales. Okay, so rather than working in full capacity as a sales manager, Ted may also choose that I will only work as a sales representative. That may be one consequence of this decision, or he may also resign from the company. But remember, however, the short-term costs of having to find a new sales manager. Yeah, there is some cost involved in finding a new sales manager. Some damage is going to happen, but it is going to be only for short-term. And a new rep, finding a new rep, if Mr. Ted Cook resigns. So the Lorna Kelly, the marketing manager, has to find a new sales manager and to find a new sales rep. The cost of this is outweighed with the benefits of having a full-time manager, even if Mr. Ted resigns, okay, from the job. Okay, in that case, okay, whatever problem the company is going to face for to find a new sales manager and a new sales rep, okay, will be compensated by the benefits of having a full-time manager who will be able to allocate, devote his entire time to in organizing and managing the sales force. Okay, see, so beautifully and in a simple way, the two alternatives are identified and each alternative is evaluated on their advantages and disadvantages. And the alternative, okay, which helps solve the problem at hand, and the alternative which helps the company in the long run performance is selected. So your decision. So when you write the answer, always remember, when you write the answer, should Lorna Kelly ask Ted Cook to give up his accounts? How do you think Kelly should handle this problem? Just most of the students, what you do, okay, many times you don't address the question directly. You go on writing theory in general. You have to address the question. You have to make a decision. But some students who address the question or who answer the situation there, they never have considered alternative decisions, the way the alternates are considered in this case as well as in the previous case. Okay, remember. So henceforth, you please remember that when you are asked to make a decision, which you have to write down, of course, in the examination, you have to consider at least two alternative decisions. One alternate, okay, you have to evaluate its advantages and disadvantages. Another alternate, its advantages and disadvantages. And then you have to choose the best alternative. That will be your answer. So in these three steps, you have to answer the question. Huh? Remember. Okay. Yeah. So only if you'd have read, I should not repeat. I'm sorry. I should not repeat again and again. Yeah. So any questions now? Anybody who can challenge these decisions? So how asking Ted to give up his accounts, Okay, and work only as a sales manager, devote his full time as a sales manager, or he can always go back to sales as a sales representative. So how this alternative is better compared to the first one, where he is allowed to handle both? You can challenge this question. You can give, bring in new dimensions, new opinions, new views. So what I'm saying is from one dimension, but though I have considered two alternatives. Yes. Anybody who has a different viewpoint, that no, sir, this is not a better alternative. The first alternative is better, where Ted Cook should be allowed to work as a sales manager as well as a sales rep. Please justify yourself. Yeah, there is pin drop silence. Am I audible to you, students?
Yes,
yes
sir.
If any constructive feedback you want to provide, you can provide that also. Or you want to consider a third alternative. There are only two alternatives discussed in this small case, since it is a small case. And the third alternative is coming into your mind. See, that is what happens in an MBA classroom. Okay, so I request you, okay, subscribe to the Harvard YouTube channel. Okay, so they have recorded their classroom discussions and uploaded them into their YouTube channel, Harvard Business School. You can find that channel in YouTube. How the teacher runs throughout the class.
Yes, sir, I have seen.
You have seen, right? Okay.
Yes, sir.
The teacher runs throughout the class, okay, asking for simple views and opinions, and she goes and writes them on the board. Okay, then in the end, they try to evaluate each answer is an alternative in itself. And she tries to get again more information about advantages and disadvantages.